Hey guys, we've completed a big two-day job on the car. Replaced the timing belt with all of the tensioners, rollers and water pump. You will need few special toolkits which are not so expensive, something like 60 euros in total. We will strictly follow the job sequence as per manual and see what happens. Okay, let's get into it. According to the manual, the belt and the tensioner must be changed every 210,000 kilometers in case you live in the country with low levels of dust. If you live in a country with high levels of dust, then the interval is 120,000 kilometers. Here is the list of countries of high levels of dust according to the manual. Our country is not in the list, but we have decided to replace the belt at 100,000 kilometers just in case. We had a bad experience in the past when the torn belt resulted in a damaged engine. Firstly, we will need to remove the right tire and few splash guards to have more room for the work. As we are going to replace the water pump, we need to drain some of the coolant. We will remove one of the bottom hoses. Okay, let's mount back the hose and shift to the engine bay. Now it's time to move aside all of the fuel lines, fuel filter box and coolant reservoir. As per manual, the fuel lines needs to be disconnected, but actually this is not required. Coolant reservoir is fastened by two bolts behind it. We will need to remove the engine mount. Before that, we need to support the engine from the bottom with a hydraulic jack. The engine will need to slightly move up and down during the work to be able to reach different mount bolts. Undo all of the mount bolts and remove the engine mount. Remove the auxiliary belt. Start removing engine bracket bolts. As I've said, wiggle the engine up and down to be able to extract the bolts. Undo this bolt, but leave the hose as is. It shouldn't be an issue during the job. Remove the upper timing belt cover. Now remove the pulley to get access to the bolts and remove the lower cover. Okay, here we are. The arrow shows that the tension is slightly out. We've bought this crankshaft fixing tool set. It fits well. The metal quality is doubtful though. We've managed to break the pin of the tool. Turn the crank clockwise until the mark will point upwards. The arrow on the camshaft pulley must point upward as well. If it's not, then turn the crankshaft another 360 degrees. Now we can mount the crankshaft fix tool. It is not possible to mount it from the top, only from the side. Two markings on the pulley and fixing tool must match. Turn the crank back and forth to insert the pin into the engine block. Now loosen the camshaft pulley bolts. Loosen the fuel pump pulley bolts. Loosen the tensioning roller securing nut. Now turn the roller anti-clockwise using a hex key and insert another key in the recess to fix the roller. Now turn tensioning roller eccentric clockwise onto stop and tighten the nut. We have removed the idler roller and removed the belt. The belt had some cracks on it. Now install the stop pin into the camshaft pulley. If the hole is not aligned and you cannot insert the pin, then you need to turn the camshaft back and forth using a special tool. The fuel pump must also be locked with a special pin. Here we have removed the pump pulley to be able to see the pinhole and rotate the pump to lock it. Mounted back the pulley. Now let's remove all of the remaining rollers and the water pump. Time to install the new water pump. Extract the old studs using two nut method. One of the studs has remaining thread locker. We've tapped that thread using the tapper kit. Now it's time to clean the area. The new ContiTech kit comes with all of the stuff you need, including the camshaft pulley bolts. Install new studs and rollers. The pin of the tensioning roller must fit a recess in the engine. Fit the nut, but keep it loosened. This bolt should be tightened in two steps. This roller is not symmetrical, the markings should be on the outer side. We will fit it later. Now turn both pulleys clockwise. Now fit the belt as per manual sequence. Crankshaft tooth belt pulley, tensioning roller, camshaft pulley, tooth belt pulley of coolant pump and tooth belt pulley of high pressure pump. Quite a struggle even with two of us. Now mount the last roller with the Allen key. Turn the tensioner clockwise until the arrow will reach the center or slightly past the center. Tighten the nut in two steps. Now tighten the camshaft pulley anti-clockwise using the special tool and make fast the camshaft pulley and the fuel pump bolts. We've noticed that the tensioner arrow lost its spot, so we have decided to tighten it up again, even though there was nothing said about it in the manual. Now remove all of the pins and stoppers. If they are tight to come out, slightly move the crankshaft back and forth. We've noticed that the arrow lost the correct position, so had to adjust the tensioner again. Now turn the engine clockwise. Two full rotations of the crankshaft and fix the crankshaft with the fixing tool again. Tensioner arrow must be in the center or max 5 mm to the right. Now try inserting the camshaft pin. We couldn't do it. The pump pin is not required anymore. The manual says the following. To fix this, there is a procedure. Pull out the crankshaft fixed tool pin from the engine and turn the engine clockwise or anti-clockwise until you could insert the camshaft fixing pin. Loosen the camshaft pulley bolts. Now turn the crankshaft clockwise or anti-clockwise to be able to insert the fixing tool pin. Now tighten the camshaft pulley bolts. Now remove all of the pins and turn the engine to full rotations clockwise again. Install the crankshaft fixing tool again and the camshaft pin. The pin should go in. And it does. The fuel pump pin couldn't get in, indeed, as per manual advice. Now change the pins on the special tool and counterhold the pump pulley. Meanwhile, turn the camshaft bolts the required angle. That's it. We have decided to spin the engine the last time and check whether the pin will go in. The tensioner arrow is having correct indication as well. Mission accomplished. Not sure about which brand is used as the original water pump, but the rollers and tensioner have the same brand name stamped on them as the Contitech kit we have installed. As I've said, the crankshaft tool's pin broken. We have repaired it using a bolt. Also, you can replace the belt using a Mickey Mouse method without any special tools. Just use a 6mm drill bit as pins, mark the belt pulleys using a marker, transfer marks from old belt to a new one and install it. I've seen people doing that successfully. Okay, time to clean the covers and assemble everything back. Bolts should be replaced. This hole must fit the pin. First the torque and then the angle. Now the brackets and the mount. All of the bracket and mount bolts, which should be tightened with angle, should be replaced since they are stretch type and one time use only. But we have cheated and left the old bolts. Install the rest of the stuff. Fresh G12 coolant. Time to make the first start. No any fault codes as well. Good stuff. And the final touch. Thanks for watching.